All right, we are back with another 8-4. Hopefully you guys can notice the sound quality change. Figured out some things in my mic settings and whatnot, and hopefully this is a little bit better. This pack doesn't have much going on for it. A couple of decent green cards and a guard Gomazoa and venerated teacher if you want to go that route, but I think I'm just going to take Moldiah Chandlers. It's not like a bomb or anything, but it's a solid man, so whether it's adding mana fixes too, which is pretty important. Not much here either. Basically comes down to the two color spells, Dreamstone Hedron or Ulamog's Crusher. I think Hedron's pretty fantastic, but I also need stuff to ramp to before I'm gonna just blindly take it. I think Crusher's the safer pick here. Escape Null and Soul Surge Elemental are fine, but it's gonna go with the fatty. Okay, here's some cards. Drake Umbra's a pretty good splash in any type of green deck, so that's a definite option. Otherwise, we have to take one of these plethora of white cards and maybe get ourselves into trouble. Like, we take any of these, the person next to us is going to take one of those for sure. So I think I'm just going to stay out of that mess and take a Drake Umbra. I don't think it's that much worse than any of those cards. Dawnguard Invoker and Knight of Cliffhaven are both obviously very good. But even Kabir Vindicator is fine as well. Here we have another Crusher, which we're not going to take this early. And I guess we're just going to take this Gross Spasm, which is fine. I like the card. It's not superb or anything like that, but it does what you need it to do. Man, there's another Knight of Cliffhaven. It's either that or Evolving Wilds. I don't know who this is, but we're not going to talk to him right now. I guess we'll just take Evolving Wilds. I don't really want to move into white after passing all that white stuff. And I don't really like white anyway. It doesn't really go with ramp or anything like that. It could be wrong to pass the knight there, but I think we'll get paid off in the long run for it. Skywatcher Adept's fine. Better than Sea Beyond, probably, in this deck. Passing some white cards again, a black card. But yeah, I'm fine with taking an Adept. Go blue-green's pretty decent color combination. You kind of get the ramp, and you get some of the cool blue cards like Narcolepsy and Regress and stuff really good in the deck. Not the greatest start ever, but it's acceptable. I've definitely won with worse. This guy is all hobgoblin it up. There's a Wildheart Invoker, another Knight of Cliffhaven. Could have three of those. It's pretty insane. So we're passing a lot of those, but that's okay, because we get a pretty good card here for us. Multiple Merchant's Gaze as well, so something to keep in mind. And a McKinney Griffin, wow. Which, shipping the nuts, but it's alright. This is definitely one of those points where you're like, well, I should have been white, but I mean, white to me usually is not good unless you get all, like, you get that many good white cards. Like, if any one, like, I would say one of those knights don't come, and then like maybe one of the Dawnglare Invoker packs don't come, and then you end up with a pretty awkward deck where white is on the back burner to whatever other color you're playing. Fleeting Distraction's fine. Pen and Blade's fine. Neither of them are super exciting. I guess we'll go with the Pen and Blade. We might get some like Predators and stuff later on. None of this is good. Take a 3/5. Decent start. Looks like we're going to be pseudo aggro. We'll take a Distortion Strike. We're going to have other outs to Narcolepsy, and we should have Naturalize or Regret that, so I'm not too worried about missing out on a Crab Umbra. This card's good for racing. Definitely need some help, but we got some foundation cards, which is fun. We could splash pretty easily, too. We already have a Gross Spasm, Evolving Wilds, and Moldiah Channelers. So, like, opening up a Stagger Shock or Vendetta is not the worst. Sure, I'll take a Lay Bear. And a Gravity Well. The guy looks kind of awkward in there. Foil to Mystify. Should not be that late. This guy's like, I don't know, just does not look like a comfortable Umbra. Snap up a mountain. Let's see. Wild Heart Invoker, Flame Slash. I like Flame Slash. It's not really the type of card I was looking for when I was talking about splashing. So I think I'm just going to go with the Wild Heart Invoker here. Continue to cut green going one way and maybe get hooked up for it later. Flame Slash is definitely good, but Wild Heart Invoker is not a bad card by any stretch of the imagination. And Flame Slash, I mean, it's an okay splash card, but like I definitely like splashing Heat Ray more just because you're able to take out anything when you finally get your color set up. And Flame Slash, you can kill most things, but you know, if we take a Flame Slash then and get past a pack with nothing but a Vendetta or something, we feel pretty awkward. So if Wild Heart Invoker's not in that pack, I obviously take Flame Slash, but he's a good enough man that I feel comfortable taking him. Pretty good with the Dracumbra on him. Never actually done it before, but I don't know how he's supposed to fit into a Dracumbra. He's got two pieces to him. Maybe he just stops riding that dude and jumps in here. I don't know. This guy does look more vicious, though. These are generally not the things I think about, but when in Rome. Alright, we got some interesting ones here. Orinarlid. We already have a Dracumbra. Not that that really matters. There's a Snakeumbra in this pack, which we might table, though. Halmar Wave Watch is also very good. And we're not going to take a third Wild Heart Invoker. So it basically comes down to a 2-drop or a 3-drop. We have no 2-drops right now, so that's something worth noting. I don't actually know which of those guys I want more. We have a Spiderumbra too, I suppose. We'll just take an Orinarlid, I think. And then we'll take a Plockworm. I was going to take a Wave Watch. I was going to get excited, but I like having a couple of top-end guys in a green aggro deck, because you usually end up with some redundant ramp, and then see, that's what I was talking about. So we could take a Wave Watch here, or you have with the Splash Vendetta. And like this card seems like a fantastic splash for us, so I think I'm going to take it. I like the Wave Watch, but we just passed up on 3 Wave Watches, which makes me feel a little bad since we have no 2-drops as of right now. Not going to be playing this Pendulblade, it looks like. Probably not going to play this Distortion Strike either. But I mean, we got pretty sweet cards in all during that. We got an Orinarlid, a Plockworm, and a Vendetta. So, can't complain too much. This guy's definitely good for racing. I'd like to see an Ondu Giant or another Growth Spasm. We passed some good cards that would come back, though. Prophetic Prism, Snakeumbra. Here's a Kozilek Spreader. It's pretty exciting. Not quite Ondu Giant, but we have 2 guys we're ramping into, so that's fine. And Seagate Oracle's good, but not up to the level of the Predator. Bramble Snap is a solid 2-drop. We just got a Predator to go with him. We'll probably get some more Token Makers. We have Growth Spasm. Definitely better than Naturalize, which will be fine in the sideboard, but Bramble Snap's one of those cards that, when good, is just insane, and he's a must-deal-with 2-drop, which is rare in this format. I mean, most of them are literally rare. You have, like, the Tusk Caller. I guess there's a couple 1-drops in there, like Ghouljaw's Assassin, stuff like that. Coral Helm Commander. This deck's definitely turning out better now. I played Unified Will before. I'd probably be more likely to play it over the Laybear, so depends on the matchup, but I'll take it. Not a card I'm excited about by any means, but definitely would like some Narcolepsies. I would definitely, if that Snakeumbra tables, I'd be pretty happy, especially now that we have an Orinarlid, a Bramble Snap, a Skywatcher Adept. Frostwind Invoke would be good for this deck if we get any of those. Just some like guys with evasion, basically. Well, there you go. Definitely going to take the Frostwind Invoker over the Sebion. I like Sebion and all, but we need guys. We only have 9 of them right now, and that's if we play them all. I mean, it looks like all of our guys are playable, but I will happily take a little flying dude. He's really good in green. Just like, I mean, look at all of our stuff. You get this stuff flying, and it gets pretty absurd. For the same reason that Dracumbra is good in green.